Boom, shakalaka, boom, 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 shakalaka, boom.
Good cup of coffee.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another Mindful Monday. For those who do not know me, I am in Hawaii, and every single Monday we'll be doing a Mindful Monday. I missed last weekend because... what was I doing? But the topic of today is I wanted to talk about finding your gift, not your passion, okay? I recently, was it last weekend, I listened to one of my friend's podcasts, Kamari, Prince Kamari, and it's called Prolific Space. You can find it on Spotify, you can find it on Anchor, you can find it on, I don't know which platforms, but I will put the link down below if you are interested in watching some of his episodes. And there is an episode coming out, I believe, today. So the link will be down below, don't you worry, and do check out his podcast. But there was a line in the conversation that he had with his first guest, and it really touched me and connected with me a lot. How a lot of people ask, oh, how do I find my passion, or how do I succeed in my talent, or stuff like that, right? And I remember there was a line that said, find your gift rather than your passion, because your gift is what you are God-given and you are born with, and that is where you channel most of your energy into finding your passion, right? So most of us have God-given gifts, like amazing voices. There are so many people I know with amazing voices who sing, and their God-given gift is that, but they naturally do not channel into being an artist, but they can touch people through other ways, but through their voice. So that's really, really touching. And we have people who have a natural gift of being funny, and they not necessarily want to become comedians, but they do love in putting some joy into some people's lives. So, but today I really want to talk about finding your gift rather than finding your passion. Since we're all in quarantine right now, Rondon coffee is the best coffee. If you want to fight me, feel free. But I do want to talk about ways of finding your gift. So most of us, or some of us, or many of us are in quarantine right now, and not working, going outside, not going to school, and we spend most of the time, let's say, behind our screens, in our rooms, watching Netflix and stuff like that. But one of the ways I experienced of finding my gift is introspection. What is introspection? Introspection is when you give that time to yourself to find your inner gift or inner child or inner self that you have not experienced ever or experienced in a long time. So that could be through meditation, yoga, that could be through sports, even simply taking a walk outside, right? So I do want to talk about introspection, how it does play a major role in finding your gift, because you are centering all that energy and pushing out all the distraction that you have, either it being your phone, either it being music, either it being, I don't know, whatever it is, but channeling out all those distractions and focusing on listening to your inner voice. And that's where you seek the highest potential of yourself and look within and finding that gift, that God-given gift that you do have, or probably you haven't found, but it is there, and you know that it is there. And using that gift does help you finding your passion. Like I say, my gift is talking, and not just talking in just rambling my mouth here and there. I love connecting with people. I love speaking to people. I love just sharing some wisdom or information that I do acquire, and also connecting with other people and learning more about them, right? And using that gift that I do have helps me with my passion, which is visual storytelling. So connecting with other people helps me tell stories in the way that I usually want to. So for people who have amazing voices and are finding their passion through music, and not necessarily want to go through the whole process of becoming a musician, a high top musician. We do have those musicians who just share their covers, or just share their their gift with us on Instagram, either it being Snapchat or TikTok, them sharing that gift and connecting with other people. Say introspection and giving time to yourself to find what's within. Two, stepping out of your comfort zone. It is really, what's the word? It is really scary. It is really, because you don't know what is outside your comfort zone, right? And the only way to find out what's outside your comfort zone is stepping into it and taking that and making that step, right? And channeling all that energy, that because there's a lot of fear when we step back and we do not want to face our fears and go into things that make us uncomfortable. But the only thing that's stepping us, that's keeping us back, is the fear, and that fear is what we have created within our mind or within our body, and have expectations of things going a certain way. If we might think that it's gonna go downwards, but who knows, if you do get into it, it might go upwards, right? It might come out as a whole different experience than you ever imagined. So stepping out of your comfort zone, trying new things that you never ever tried, curiosity, that is one of the ways of finding your gift, is when certain things make you curious and you want to try out, just try out a little bit of everything. What makes you curious and what you want to, and what makes you joyful and happy, because you are the only person who knows yourself. So what makes you happy? What do you love the most? What makes you curious? That thing that makes you curious right now, or those things that make you curious, try your best and look into it and build a connection with it, because most of the times that is where all our success or our happiness or our gifts lie. But we are afraid to take that major step and getting out of our comfort zone, trying new things, whether it be skydiving, whether it being scuba diving, whether it being you want to try painting, playing the piano, you want to try traveling, you want to try a lot of things, blogging, you want to try vlogging, you want to try every single thing. Because I always had this fear of vlogging, because the fear of stepping outside and holding my camera in front of every single person, I have that fear of being judged. Oh, what's this guy doing? What's he doing holding a camera? And I do want to get out of that comfort zone once we are allowed to go outside and allowed to film. So hopefully when I do get that time to step outside with my camera, I do want to step out of my comfort zone and start vlogging with my camera and talking about and sharing experiences that I am having with other people. So that thing that is making you uncomfortable, there is going to get to a time where you would have to face it and you would have to fight against it. And who knows, in that thing that makes you so scared, so anxious, you might find that there's a lot of beauty and growth into that thing. So take time with yourself, grow, and within time, with time and patience, because you only know yourself best, right? Do not let other people's expectations or time limit put pressure on you. You have your own time and you know how long it will take you to get over that fear. So put your energy into that, and within time, you find that thing that you once feared was just an image that you built up in your head, right? So focus on the best outcome that you could ever experience out of it. Three, experiencing new things. This is a time, because we are on lockdown. Yo, what's this? This is disturbing me. I'm shooting a YouTube video.
Right now?
Yeah. Okay. Who's that? Daj. Everyone just calling me. Yo, bro. What's up? Yes, sir.
Oh, find it.
Huh?
What are you doing, bro?
I'm shooting a YouTube video, and you people just decide to disrupt me while I'm shooting my YouTube video. What is going on?
Oh, really?
Yeah. Let me show you.
Can I be there?
You want to be in the YouTube video?
Hey, guys.
Alright. Okay. Uh-huh. You got something to say?
Are you now?
I'm literally shooting a YouTube video that I'm uploading tonight, so cool. So everyone just decides to disturb me right now, but yeah, where was I? I was talking about experiencing new things. The life we were living before is what we called normal, right? And now that we are at home and experiencing a whole world pandemic, looking back at the life we called normal kind of looks really funny, because no one saw this coming, and no one knew that this life that we called normal, looking back at it, it's a life that a lot of people did not want to live, right? Living everything as rushing, living by the second, and not even pausing a little bit and trying something that you've always wanted to try, right? I've always wanted to play the piano, but the normal life that we called the normal life is what was before is I would wake up, go to work, come back, laptop, talk to friends, spend time on my phone, if not Netflix, and I would not channel a lot of my time into the things that I wanted to experience, right? Those little things I wanted to experience, like learning how to draw, learning how to play an instrument, okay? Learning a new skill. So experiencing new things, like, because you cannot experience new things if you have that routine. So if you do have a routine life, and a lot of us, if you look at it, our life is really routine, where it's either school, if it's not school, it's uni. If it's not uni, it's spending time on social media. If it's not that, I don't know. But the routine life, getting out of that routine life, trying things that you've never experienced before. It can simply be a workout, honestly, because I've never tried out yoga. A friend of mine did recommend trying out yoga, how it can help you with a lot of things like stress, anxiety, discomfort, and how simply yoga, from it being something that tests your body's limit, but also tests your mind's limit of concentration and calmness. So trying your best to experience a new thing that you've always pushed away and hesitated to do might be that place where you are trying to find that gift of yours, okay? Your passion. It is amazing to have a passion, and a lot of us do have a passion for a lot of things. I have a passion to draw, a passion to sing, a passion to dance, a passion to photograph, a passion to travel, a passion to cook. Me knowing my gifts helps me find or channel or readjust the passion that I have been looking into. So my word of advice would be spending time with yourself and finding that God-given gift you have, which will help you to channel into your passion, okay? So be mindful that it's the gift that you have. Nobody else has. Nobody's gonna hand it to you. You have it within yourself, and you are the only person who has the energy to seek it, okay? So be mindful that it's that God-given gift, because I believe a lot of us have purpose. Everybody has a purpose on this life. We're not just here to exist. We're here for a purpose, and we all find a purpose in life at different stages of our lives. I've not found mine, but there is so much in your purpose and that God-given gift that you do have, that where you find, like I said, the greatest potential of yourself. So, either it being after this Mindful Monday, go and try spend time by yourself. Put your phone on mute. Put your laptop away, okay? Either you can put on some music, but just sit down for like 5 to 10 minutes, think. You don't even have to think, just sit there, relax, listen to yourself, be calm, no external noises, just calmness, you're relaxed. And that 5, 10 to 10 minutes is where you are centered with yourself. So give yourself that time and energy. As much as you give other people that time and energy of texting back or even calling them, give yourself the same love and attention that you give to other people. So, what did you get out of this today? Is you can even get a journal. Get a journal and write down what you experienced or what you thought of during those 5 to 10 minutes, okay? It can really help you envision the things that have been confusing you upstairs. So yes, be mindful that it's your gift that channels your passion. So find your gift and your passion will make sense. Thank you very much. Okay, next time I do hope you grab your cup of coffee, okay, and join me on the next Mindful Monday. But if it helps, comment down below if I've helped or if I've said anything that you have been wanting to hear or something that you want me to talk about. Just comment down below and subscribe somewhere there, wherever it is. Just smash that subscribe button and I will see you in the next Mindful Monday. Okay, so bye bye. Yeah. Was I recording?